On some airplanes, the engine is angled to the right to counteract multiple effects that try to turn it to the left. The propeller doesn't push the air straight back, it also gives it a spin. The air twists around the body of the airplane until it hits the rudder and turns the plane to the left. This effect is most pronounced on takeoff because the high throttle and the low speed create a helix with a high angle of attack. Then there is the P factor, or propeller factor as you will. Usually planes are pointing up relative to the direction of travel. This means that one side of the propeller has a steeper angle than the other side. In this case, the planes will have more thrust on the right side, pulling the plane to the left. The propeller also pushes against the air and the air pushes back. This creates torque to the left, called the torque factor. This is not simply solved by angling the motor. However, as I explained in another video, using the ailerons to counter this torque and roll the plane to the right might lead to adverse yaw to the left. And at minimally viable speeds, at takeoff for example, the use of ailerons can cause flow separation on the lifting side, which would actually decrease the lift capacity and make the problem even worse. So a slight tendency to the right might be desirable. The propeller is also prone to gyroscopic precession. The tip of the propeller moves to the right, and when the tail of the airplane lifts up at takeoff, for example, the tip of the propeller is pushed forward. If you add these factors together, the tip will move right forward, turning the airplane to the left. And in the same way, when you go left, the airplane turns up, and when you turn up, it turns to the right, and when you turn right, the airplane turns down. This gyroscopic precession has little to do with the angle of the motor. I just thought it was a fun fact. Make sure to like and subscribe so I can make more of these videos.